Good evening. Today we are going to write a program to print the given pattern of stars. Consider this problem is given to you in the exam. This type of problem always come for 10 marks. Okay, so now if you see the pattern given to you into this problem, it is not the left justified triangle of stars, correct? So whenever you print anything on the screen using any programming language, it always start printing the output from left to right of the screen, correct? So we need to also consider into this problem the number of spaces on every row. So if you see this pattern, it has 5 rows and 5 columns, and there are also spaces on every row. We need to consider all those spaces before printing this pattern of star. On the first row there are 4 spaces and there is a star. From left hand side if you count, there are 4 spaces and 1 star. On the second row there are 3 spaces and then 2 stars. On third row there are, sorry, on the second row there are 3 spaces and 2 stars, correct? And on third row there are 2 spaces and 3 stars. On fourth row there is only 1 space and 4 stars. On fifth row there is no space and 5 stars. So the logic that we get from this image or the pattern is, the as you go from one row to another row, the number of spaces is decreasing, whereas the number of stars are increasing. It means this is the same pattern that we have seen in the first program of patterns, that is left justified triangle of stars. It is similar to that only, but we need to include the spaces on every row. Then only we will see that it gets adjusted like a right justified triangle of stars. Now we will start writing the code and we will understand how to include spaces on every row in this pattern. We will start with the header files, hash include yesterday.h, hash include conio.h, void main, then opening bracket, and we will declare all the variables required into this program. There is ij, I is for row, j is for column, k is for spaces. So we needed the third for loop for printing spaces. So we have taken a variable k for that. And m is the limit for printing the spaces on every row. Now I assigned m to 4 because if you see on the first row there are 4 spaces. That's why I assigned m value to 4. Then this line will clear the screen. This for loop, outer for loop, if you see it is written in a forward direction. It is a forward loop which starts with 1 and it ends with 5. It means it is going to be executed 5 times. It indicates that there are 5 rows. Okay, this 5 rows. Inside the outer for loop, we write a loop for printing spaces first. If you see the pattern carefully, before printing the stars, we need to first print the spaces and then print the stars. So, inside the outer for loop, we have taken a k loop which is responsible for printing these spaces. Okay, so it is written like this: k equal to 1, k less than equal to m, k plus plus. It means that it starts with 1 and it goes till m. That many spaces it will going to print on that particular row. After printing the spaces, we take another for loop, that is j, which is responsible for printing the stars on that particular row. After printing the spaces, after printing the stars, we use this line, printf line, to go to the next row from the current row. When you go to the next row, we know that from the pattern that when you go to the next row, the number of spaces is decrementing. That's why we decrease the limit of printing the spaces by 1 here, m equal to m minus 1. From here, we'll close the program. Outer for loop, we'll close the program here. And now we'll see the handrun and we'll check how this code will going to print the above pattern. Now we'll start with the outer for loop, where I value is 1, condition is true. It allows us to enter into the inner code, where we have two different loops. One is responsible for printing spaces, whereas another is responsible for printing the star on the same row. Okay. Initial value of m was 4. It means that when I value becomes 1, this loop will go from k equal to 1, k less than or equal to 4, k plus plus. It means 4 times this code gets executed, and this will print 4 stars on first row. Four spaces on the first row. K loop is responsible for printing spaces. See, check it here. In the first row, there are 4 spaces. Here, the job of the K loop ends and the job of J loop starts. After completing the K loop, the cursor goes to the J loop, where we'll see how it is written. J equal to 1, J less than equal to 1, because for the first time, I value was 1, J plus plus. It means this code gets executed only once on the first row, and it prints one star on the first row. So there are 4 spaces and 1 star. So that at the end of the J loop, it means that it completes the first loop. After completing the first loop, to go to the next row, we use this printf line slash n. So this shift the cursor to the second row. After going to the second row, we'll decrementing the limit of printing the number of spaces. On second row, there is 1 space less than the previous row. That's why we decremented m by 1 here. From here, the cursor goes to the outer for loop, that is I plus plus. It means the second row started and the condition is true. On second row, the K loop becomes k equal to 1, k less than equal to 3, k plus plus. It print 3 spaces on the second row. This loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 2, j plus plus. It means it gets executed 2 times, print 2 stars on the second row. After printing that, we go to the next row by this line. When you go to the third row, value of m again gets decremented by 1 and it becomes 2. From here it goes back to the outer for loop, where I becomes 3. It means we are on the third row. M value is 2. This k loop becomes k equal to 1, k less than equal to 2, k plus plus. It print 2 spaces on the third row, and j loop will print 3 stars on the third row. After that, this line shift the cursor to the fourth row, where m value becomes 1, it goes back to the outer for loop, where it increments the value of I, that is, that it becomes 4, and the condition becomes true. Here, this loop will print only 1 space on the fourth row, because m value was 1. After that, this j loop prints 4 stars on the same row, that is fourth row. After that, this line shift the cursor to the next row, that is fifth row. When you are at the fifth row, m value becomes 0. From here, it increments the value of I becomes 5. Condition is true. In the last iteration, the value of m was 0. This loop becomes k equal to 1, k less than equal to 0, k plus plus. The condition is false for the first time itself. That's why it never executes this code on the fifth row. It means there is no space on the fifth row. Directly goes to the j loop, where j value becomes 1, j less than equal to 5, j plus plus. It means that on the fifth row, this j loop will going to print 5 stars. After that, this line shift the cursor to the sixth row and m value becomes minus 1. From here, it goes back to increment the value of I, that is I value becomes 6. When I value becomes 6, the outer condition becomes false and this stops the execution of the
for loop.
This way it prints the pattern like this. Okay, so we studied two different things into this program. That is, this pattern is not left justified, it is right justified triangle of star. Whenever a triangle like this is given in the exam, we must consider all the spaces on every row and then print the pattern of stars. So this ends the program on printing the stars pattern. If you have any doubt, please ask me now. Okay, thank you.